This week, it's all about introducing you to Apple's Spotlight. Now, Spotlight is an amazing search tool on both macOS and iOS. It is incredibly powerful, but one of the things that I find quite surprising is how few people have actually A, discovered it, and B, using it. It's something that I use all the time. I use it to search for people, I use it to search for documents, I also use it as an app launcher on my macOS. It is powerful, it is fantastic, and after you've watched this episode, if you've never used Spotlight before, then you're going to be using it all the time. And that's what this episode is all about. So before we go any further, I would just like to ask, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by hitting that little like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest news, tips and tricks on using Apple's productivity system, then please subscribe to this channel. Okay, let me now take you into my macOS and also iOS and show you how to get the most out of Spotlight. Okay, so before we get into this, let me just explain what Spotlight is. Spotlight is basically Apple's search, system-wide search functionality. So all you need to do to bring it up is press Command Space. Now, I've actually changed this in my own system because I need a Korean language input system. So as you can see, what I did just before I began doing this video, I actually did a search for Screen Flow. I'm using it as an application launcher. So for example, I can type in Safari, hit return, and it's going to open up Safari for me, just like that. So that's essentially how this works. So what you need to do is, you can bring this up, I can type in mail and type in space, because Mail Butler was there, it's still bringing up Mail Butler. So what I can do is come down to here, press return, and immediately I bring up, well, not almost immediately, this is my old computer, so he's a bit slow. In fact, he's actually very slow. But it does actually open up my mail. Oh, look at that. 615 emails. But actually, that's simply because I only have one mailbox here, which is my Gmail account. And that's, you can see I haven't checked my email in here for a very, very long time. So let's just quit mail, because this episode is not about mail. So I'm going to come out of that. So what you need to do to set Spotlight up first, and I'm going to show you how to do this on a phone as well. You can do this on your phone. It's also available. But let's do Spotlight first. Go into the Spotlight in your system preferences right here. And what you'll see is you've got basically for everything is right here. Now, I don't have very much set up on this particular Mac. As I mentioned before, this is actually my demo Mac. It's my old old laptop. But I can put these on, I can turn these off. So I've got Spotlight suggestions, which I say, well, I don't really want those. I can turn that off. System preferences, don't really need that. Yes, and I can just go through all this, and I don't want fonts in there. And I can just find, you know, add in things that I want to do. So that's it. You can change that. You can do all sorts of things in there. So let's bring up Spotlight. There's a couple of things that I use this for. Let's just say that I took my weight today and I was 83.5 kilograms. I'm going to do kg. And what you'll see there is immediately, just by typing in 83.5 kilograms, I've actually got the conversion straight into pounds, and then I've got sub conversions down at the bottom. But I could possibly, and this is, I've not done this before, but let's just see. Let's see if it does that. No, it doesn't, which it does do actually on the phone, but it doesn't actually do it on here. The other one that I use this for is because I am working in Celsius. A lot of my American coaching clients obviously are using Fahrenheit. Well, today's temperature in Seoul is 10 degrees Celsius. So if I just type Celsius, and it's probably because I'm not actually, there we go, 10 degrees. You probably have to, yeah, there we go. So I just put 10 degree and it's automatically picked up Celsius, and that's 50 degrees Fahrenheit. So there you go. And if you really want to know, it's 283 kelvins. So there's another way that you can do it. You can convert things just by typing things in there. The thing that I use this most for though is if I'm looking for something specific. But because this is my my demo account. I don't really have that much set up in here, but I can type in Todoist. I can also type in a name. So let's just type in newsletter. Let's see what happens when I type in newsletter. Well, there you go, straight away. I've got all the details, like I've got images for newsletter. I go down here, I've got PDF documents. I can go down to here and suddenly I've got all mail messages which related to my mail message. Let's just say I tap on that one and that's going to show it up. Brian Tracy's email is going to come in. Again, I have to be careful here because the only email account I have my newsletter account set up in this computer, so these are not necessarily the ones that I actually get. So I get all the ones from Brian Tracy, but there you go. That's the thing. I can actually search for specific newsletters. If I want to see that letter completely, I just tap on that and it will open it up in Mail. So that's how you use it on your Mac. And you can actually resize this, and I think you can actually resize it better than that, but there you go. So that's it, and it's really, really quick. So what I would suggest you do is set this up on your keyboard shortcuts. As I say, I use Shift Command S for me, but on this particular computer I'm using Control S. You can set this up however way you want to do it. To do that, you just need to go into your keyboard shortcuts. Let's just have a look. Go into here, go back into System Preferences. I go into my keyboard and you can pick up shortcuts here as Spotlight, and now I've got here, so I've got Option S or Control S. You can choose whichever one you want. So if you want to do the new one, I can just tap on that and then I can record another one and go Shift S, and there you go, and that's done. So there you go, that's how you can actually set up your own keyboard shortcut. So let me now go and show you. Now this is just a basic setup. I don't want to go into too much details. There's so much more that you can do with Spotlight, and what I would strongly recommend is that you have a play around with it. It's really, really very, very powerful tool. Now what I want to do is go and take you into your iPhone, and by the way, taking you into the iPhone, it also works exactly the same way on the iPad. But let me take you into your iPhone now and I will show you how to use Spotlight on your iPhone. Okay, so to actually access your Spotlight on your mobile device, you need to swipe down from the middle of the screen. So you swipe down and you access Spotlight. Now Spotlight will give you all sorts of options. So the first thing you're going to see on your phone is the last few applications that you've used on your phone. Well, this is so much more powerful than that. As I showed you before, if I put 83.5, and as I mentioned there, I can actually convert this into stone by tapping on that, and it'll tell me 13.11 stone. And I can go onto the web. You can do so much more. Actually, Spotlight on your mobile devices, whether it's the iPad or your iPhone, is incredibly powerful. If I put 50 degrees, and it's going to go 50 degrees Fahrenheit, 50 degrees Celsius to Fahrenheit. So it's going to go, that's a little bit too hot. Let's go back in and do that. Actually, it's 10 degrees today. So let's do 10 degrees. And to Fahrenheit, I can go in and sure enough, it will come up there. And also you get Siri suggestions there too. So that will come up and you can actually go into your Safari. Again, you can use it as an app launcher. So you'll notice there's no Safari. So if I type in Safari or type in SAF, I can get Safari and that will come up. Tap on that and it will open up my Safari. So that's fantastic. Now another one is that you can actually search for people. So I can search for my mum. I can just type in mum and sure enough it's going to come up there. So mum, it'll also come up Mumford and Son. So if I tap on that, it will probably open up or allow me to open up in Apple Music if I wish. If I go down here, videos, YouTube, Twitter, there's all sorts of things I can actually go into there. So there's all sorts of wonderful ways that you can utilize the search function Spotlight in your iPhone. And again, if you go into settings, you can play around with the settings. So if I go to Siri and search, and you can go down to here, suggestions in search, Siri suggestions, that will all come up. And you can just play around with this. And actually, maybe that's not the one that I want. So we can go down here. It is the one that you want. It's to go into there, Siri and search. That's the one that you want. And you can just play around with that and it will go through all the various things that you want to add into your options. So there you go. So that's it. all you need to know about setting up. And I say, this is just the basic version of Spotlight. You can go so much deeper with this. It's such a powerful tool. You can get a lot out of it and you can get a lot of use. It'll search for your emails, it'll search for your messages, it'll search for your notes. It's really quite a powerful tool. And once you learn how to use it properly, you probably find that you start using this way more than you use any other search function on your phone, devices, or your computer. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my Learning Center and is incredible value. And it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, Reminders, and Calendar into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.